How did you know it was my cousin Elwood?
The missing car keys were the first tip-off.
And this magazine Shaggy and Scooby brought back is a clue to why he wanted the coin.
That's right. And Lilo was in on the whole scheme.
I get it. He was going to use the Albert Trost disguise for his getaway.
It was the only way to get the pearls past all the police roadblocks.
When the honest guards made their rounds, they thought the museum was empty and locked up.
Mr. Grizzly, I mean Sammy the Shrimp, hijacked that missing Blink's armored car.
And that enabled them to stay inside all night and work the drill into the mint.
And all the smoke and sizzling handprints were created with those chemicals we found in the old pharmacy.
And then there was the tiny picture of Elwood that Scooby-Dum found on the end of his nose.
Wells had hidden the pearls inside some frozen oysters from Sam's fish market.
But the most important clue was when you told us that Merlin's ghost always appeared at 15 minutes after midnight.
But we didn't figure that out until the butler mentioned that the phone line was down.
Which meant Elwood had to be lying when he told us that he had telephoned the bank manager.
Right. Bender ducked inside the scoreboard room, disguised himself as Ellsworth, and pretended he'd been jumped by the Phantom.
The zombie was trying to find Dilly to give him the coin, but we kept showing up at the wrong time.
Then Wells used his expert skill at cabinet making to construct a secret hiding place for himself in the base of the real demon's cabinet.
Then we found the red silk scarf, which is also used in magic acts.
Mr. Crenshaw got his demon costume from the museum in the underground city.
Then they posed in this tableau as wax dummies.
That's when Lila and Roger came up with the voodoo scheme to scare the group into signing away all the rights to the money.
But we found the matchbook that connected him to the old sailor.
We figured they ditched the real wax dummies in the basement and put on their clothes.
It all adds up to the solution to the mystery of the ghost of the demon shark.
The mystery of the underground demons was sure a spooky adventure.
Spooky? What's so spooky about a bunch of hokey old hissing demons?
Come on back, Scooby. It's only a steamed lobster.